Hey guys, today I'm going to show you why my Dell XPS is kind of exploding. We're going to try and fix it. I'm going to talk to you about the experience that I had with the support. And well, it's lockdown time, it's a holiday, it's Christmas season, the best time of the year, spending at home. And I finally come around to do things that I normally never have time to. So let's get started. So as you can see, this is my notebook. I bought it in 2016, something like that, and I used it for 2 years, nearly every day, and it was really good. I mean, the XPS series is really good. It's really well built. It has awesome build quality, and it's super durable. I mean, it's fast. It's everything. But what I didn't expect was the trackpad coming at me. And if you take a closer look here, it's really far apart where it should be, and it's not working. And at the start I thought, like, what the f***? What's happening? And shortly after I noticed that under the trackpad there's the battery, and the battery is starting to blow up. It's a bad sign. It's a fire hazard and it needs to be fixed. And I took a closer look at it. There was a patch for the BIOS of this notebook. It's the 9550 or something like that. And in the BIOS patch notes, there were a statement from Dell like, fix power issues with exploding batteries. So they fixed that, but not soon enough for me. And I wanted to get support like 2 years ago or something like that after I bought it. And they were like, no, you can't. Call the number and it costs by minute. And I was really sad because I know what was wrong with it. I needed to exchange a battery and need to buy a new battery. But there was no new battery found at the Dell support site. I mean, I could buy cables and extensions and all that bullshit that I didn't need. And, well, I couldn't buy a battery. So I was looking for second-hand batteries for exactly that model. And I found a few on Amazon. And I found a few on, you know, some shady sites. And a lot of comments were like, you cannot do this. The battery won't work. You know, they bought the battery, people built, opened the laptop up, exchange the battery, and it didn't work. So I thought, like, not gonna do that. I set it aside and was like, never gonna take a look at it again. I'm disappointed. Yeah, finally got around and I ordered a package because this is what I got from Dell support. I called the number, I paid by minute, and I was talking to a guy and explained my issues, and he knew exactly what it was all about because, I guess they're having these issues a lot. And so he said to me, you know what, I'll make you an exclusive offer. He's like, why exclusive offer? Why can't I just buy the battery from your store? I send you an email, give me your email address. I send you exclusive offer, pay me, and then you get it. I was like, are we at a bazaar or something? I don't know, but okay. So I gave him my email address and everything. And he sent me an exclusive offer. It was 85 euros. I paid it up front. It was a really weird experience, you know? I couldn't they just put it in the store or something, but okay. And then I got this package here. So this is really weird. So I mean, the packaging is nice and everything. And here's a card where it tells me to please read these instructions. And there are two separate parts, English and German. And they say if you are a premium customer, you can, put the battery inside and put the other battery back in, and they take care of the rest of the exploded battery. But, my support is not really premium, so I guess I'm not a premium customer. There are recycle order something. There's a website on here where they tell me I could recycle it somewhere with a given number and they know what to do with it. I'll try. I'll tell you later what happened to that. So, there's nothing else inside this box except this box. And that's the battery, I guess. Okay, so it's the same packaging material, and inside here is the new battery. This is what it should look like, and we're going to see what it looks like in a few minutes. I'm going to make some close-ups here so you can take a look at it as well. So it's pretty much a standard battery, you know. There's a connector, some screw holes to screw it down. Yeah. So now let's go and open up the notebook and take a look at the fatality inside. For removing the backplate of the notebook, I'm using my T5 Torx bit from the iFixit kit. While unscrewing, I felt a lot of pressure was released, and after removing the bottom screws, the battery expanded and pushed the cover up. I'm really curious if the trackpad would work after replacing the battery. For the two screws on the inside, below the little cover, I'm using a standard Phillips 0 bit. Looks like the battery has left some residue inside that we'll need to clean up. As you can see, the pockets on the battery nearly expanded to double their size. So before we do anything, we're going to unplug the connector. Next, we're going to use our Phillips bit again to remove the battery. As you can see, this looks really wild. Compared to the new battery, well, that's a lot better. Here underneath the battery is the trackpad. Looks like everything is okay. Let's see what happens when we put it inside. Now let's clean up some leftover dust, plug in the battery, and put it back together. As you can see, it closes again, so that's a good sign. Let's test it out. So the trackpad seems to work fine. And the power works. Great. So after a little bit of testing, I found out that everything pretty much works like it did before. Trackpad is now working, the clicks are working, everything's fine. Just the bottom is not sticking anymore. So I think that needs a little glue, but that's an easy fix. So overall, this thing is still kicking, it's really nice. Just the support was bad for me, I don't know, but other people had a great experience, they even had pickups, so maybe it's just me, you know, whatever. Yeah, thank you guys for checking out this video. Give it a like if you like it, subscribe to our channel for more content like this one. MoBro update video coming out really soon, it's our system monitoring tool. Check it out if you don't know it, I'll link it down below. Check out our forum, our socials, and see you guys next time.